Let's start with some of the basics. Breast milk production and composition. The first fluid that a mother produces is colostrum, a thick, sticky fluid that typically is yellow, orange, or white in color. Since colostrum contains a slew of immune factors, its primary role is immunological rather than nutritional. Some women can express colostrum in the last few months or weeks of pregnancy. Next comes transitional milk, which arrives during the first few days to 2 weeks after childbirth and is high in lactose. By 4 to 6 weeks after childbirth, the mother's milk is considered mature. Mature milk that is expressed during the early part of a single feeding session is called formilk. It's high in lactose and has a watery consistency. The milk expressed during the latter part of this feeding is called the hindmilk. It's high in fat and has a creamy consistency. Breast milk is an incredibly dynamic substance. It changes in composition during a single feeding, from day to night, and throughout the lactation period in response to the growing infant's needs. It's also influenced by circadian rhythms. Breast milk contains several components that transmit circadian signals to help the infant regulate its own sleep-wake cycle, with the nighttime breast milk containing higher levels of melatonin and somnogenic amino acids like tryptophan. Breast milk nucleotides, which are important structural components of DNA and RNA, also show circadian rhythmicity. Some of the nucleotides peak during the day, while others peak at night, suggesting a potential role for these nucleotides as sleep inducers. These data suggest that if an infant is fed expressed breast milk, the milk should be provided at the same time of day that it was expressed to maintain the infant's circadian rhythm. It's important to note that things you eat, drink, supplement, but even more importantly, smoke, can end up in your breast milk. Breast milk is species specific. Human breast milk contains proteins, carbohydrates, fats, vitamins, and minerals to nourish a human infant. One of the biggest differences you'll see between human milk and other types of milk is the protein content. The total protein content in human breast milk is quite a bit lower than milk from other species. One of the reasons human infants grow so slowly compared to, say, a calf. There are roughly 415 different proteins in human breast milk. These proteins provide nutrition, of course, but they also aid in the infant's digestion and supply both antimicrobial and immunological factors that compensate for deficiencies in the infant's immune system, which I'll talk about a little bit later. Breast milk contains a variety of complex carbohydrates, the most abundant of which is lactose, which provides necessary energy for the infant's brain. The second largest concentration of carbohydrates in human breast milk are non-nutritive components called human milk oligosaccharides, or HMOs for short.